Hello everyone. In this lecture, I would be discussing centrifuges. I am Akanksha Jain, assistant professor in IMS Ghaziabad. Now, centrifuge is basically a device which is used for separation of particles based upon the size, shape, and density of viscosity of the medium and the rotor speed. Now, the solutions. Is actually based on the concept of sedimentation. The particles whose density is higher than that of the solvent, they sink, and whereas the particles that are lighter, they float on the top. The greater the difference in density, the faster they move, and if there is no difference in density, the particles stay at their position. It is same as why a leaf floats on water, and whereas a stone, it sinks down. So, to take advantage of very tiny differences in density to separate various particles in a solution, gravity can of course be replaced by a more centrifugal, powerful centrifugal force, which is provided by centrifuge. So this technique plays important role in biochemistry and biotechnology, as it is a non-dispensable part of one of the other steps in every method involved in biological studies, right from the separation of cell organelles to complex experiments which involve separation of cell-cellular fractions. Coming to the different types of centrifuges and their uses, the very first type is a small bench centrifuge, which you generally find in pathology labs, where they do separation of different cell different components of blood. And so these are small centrifuges with small capacity and have a centrifugal force of 3000 to 7000. Then come this is a pick of a small bench centrifuge that you usually found in laboratories. Coming to a large capacity refrigerated centrifuge, as the name suggests, this centrifuge has larger capacity, and it is refrigerated one, so the temperature can be controlled, and it is generally used for samples in which the temperature can cause denaturation of your sample. This is a figure of a large capacity centrifuge. Coming to a high speed refrigerator centrifuge, these type of centrifuge, they have very high speed of 60,000, and they can be used, since the RPM is so high, so they can be used to collect microorganisms, cellular debris, or large cellular organelles and proteins. Coming to the ultra centrifuge, we have these centrifuges. These are of two types. They can be preparative or they can be analytical. Now, the major difference between preparative ultracentrifuge and analytical centrifuge we will be discussing in later slides, but then the centrifugal force is quite high here. They are refrigerated, they are sealed and evacuated. Now, this is a figure of a preparative ultracentrifuge. Coming to the analytical ultracentrifuge, I will be discussing difference between these two types of ultracentrifuge. This type of centrifuge, analytical ultracentrifuge, it has got a optical system. And why there's a need of optical system, that I will be discussing with you. So it has got an optical system where you can do real-time monitoring of your centrifugation. So this is an analytical ultracentrifuge. This is the ray diagram. This is the diagram of ultracentrifuge, analytical type, which has got this is a rotor in which you are placing your tubes. This is the motor that controls it. We have a light source, we have a vacuum pump. Why is there is vacuum? Because the speed of these type of centrifuge is so high that if there is air in it, then that would cause a large amount of friction between the rotor and the air, and that will lead to very high temperature. So these type of ultra centrifuge, these are generally evacuated before doing the processing. So we have a cooling jacket system also, because they are refrigerated again. Then this is an optical system with mirror, light path and detector to do real-time monitoring of ultra of your sample. Now, preparative centrifuges, these are generally have larger sample size. There is no readout system. There is no real-time monitoring. So You cannot analyze them. You can analyze only after the centrifugation is done. So preparative centrifuge is usually done when the sample size is large, and this is also mostly used. But in case of analytical centrifuge, the sample size is quite less and the optical system is there where you can do the real-time monitoring. So the sample is relatively pure and you can precisely determine the sedimentation coefficient and molecular weight of your molecule.